Hello, this is Robert Hansen at Greenhouses, under explaining wide variety of different ideals. And like you see, we use eggshells and little black containers as well, and you can see how many you can fit in there. It's got three. Two levels, okay. So far, it really does hold up to the coldness and even somewhat of harsh winds. Now, you don't want to be thinking this is sitting there next to the refrigerator, because if not, I would say it probably would be blown away on any kind of harsh wind. Okay, so this area is known to have harsh winds, zone 6 in Illinois. Okay, look at that, yeah, look at them plants. And then plastic eggshells there in the greenhouse. Now, what we're doing here is we're using potatoes and the eyes to grow more potatoes. And this is a good way of doing it. Just gotta keep an eye on the potatoes and the eyes. Okay, and we tried something new with that stuff down at the bottom for planting seeds in them. And you see, and that's, you gotta rotate, make sure it's got both sides got quite a bit of light to get the plant, the eyes to start to mature. The greenhouse does do pretty good when it comes to moisture. Yeah. Okay. Somewhat pretty well, but by itself out in the open, and you can tell, and bought some trays, pictures, okay, yeah, you want to make sure that wherever you put your greenhouse, it's not out in the open. By itself because of the wind. Okay. I spent $40-something on buying it. And it's paid for itself. It has. And you can see all different uses and all different things that you can use it for with them black things, black shells, containers. You can put the eggshell, plastic eggshells and containers in there, and they fit real good. And then why they say put water and let it go in when you make little holes. Helps with keeping the soil. It don't damages. It helps the plant. It does anyway. But yeah, and it keeps. If you ever saw these greenhouses, why you want to make sure wherever you put it, to make sure that they are so they're in a good location. Okay. That is another thing of where if some plants requires no minerals, no minerals or food, real high food is what you would use that sponge stuff. I don't know the name of it. I forget what they call it. But you see how the plants are doing in there. And that's about a week started. Okay. When it gets really good and cold, it has its limitations with the heating pad even. Okay. So that's why I was referring to when you buy heating pad and a greenhouse, and if you put both in, you want to make sure, and this is what I was referring to, it's always best to do it like that, because it helps protect the plant, and think of it like this, it filters the water, it takes the noise, takes the water, but if there's any other kind of material in the water, it leaves it there on the outside. Okay. Coconut cups. Alright. And they're still the plant's still growing in it, and it does do quite a bit of good in there. And that's a good thing to have when you start growing things. I will say that. Coconut cups. Okay. Look at that. And why we put the buckets around it is to help with keep some of the free flow air from messing with the greenhouse. Okay. And you see for yourself inside, it does that. A little bit of water turns into vapor when it reaches to that temperature of your climate. Okay. And that's my my pineapple back there. Yeah. Got 10 of them. 10 of each blue buckets. 10 gray. And each thing the way it out, and you look and you see how the whole thing, and that's at about 1 o'clock it looks like outside and on a nice summer day. It's June. It is when this is being taken. And like they say, the plant points towards the light. And you can see it actually does do that. Things of it is, you see for how it all. Okay, copy lid, you put a little bit of dirt there and get the plant started too. You can. And some plants don't that even look and tell. Okay, on how fast. They do progress. Okay. The greenhouse is about like 4 foot tall. Looks. Well, it's up to like a little bit past my hip. Well, up to my elbow anyway. I'll say 4 foot tall. This is Robert Hansen at Greenhouse. If you have things like this before, type of greenhouse or other greenhouses, or at home, if you at home gardening and you got a greenhouse, let us know how it operates and how it works for you. And if you did anything different, let us know, okay? Thank you.